Welcome to this short tutorial about how to make class requests for the June 2018 Origami USA Convention. Please take the time to read the documentation provided on the convention website. It gives a very comprehensive explanation about how this new ticketing system works. There is also a very useful frequently asked questions section. This video is just a how-to guide. So let's go ahead and get started. As you can see, I'm open to the convention website and I have clicked on the left sidebar where it says classes and teaching. You will see underneath there is a tab that says my classes. If you see over here, you can also look over here where it says, here's where you'll request your desired classes and see your class assignments. When you click on this, before June 4th, you will be taken to a page that it will not be open yet. This class page will be open on June 4th for you to request your classes. However, in order for me to demonstrate this, the web team has set up a special environment where I can choose from Convention 2017 classes so that I can show you how the process works. So here, when you do request, click on that, request your class schedule, you'll be directed to a page that looks like this. It will have your name, and it will have Saturday, Sunday, Monday, if you have signed up to take Monday classes, and top picks. All of this works pretty much like the ticketing we've done before, except for top picks, which I will explain later. So let's go ahead and look at Saturday. We're going to request class for Saturday. So we click on the link and we get to a page that looks like this. Down here is the list of classes I have requested. I don't have anything listed here yet because I haven't requested anything. Up here is the box where I will make my requests. You can, and probably will want to, look at what the menu is of what's being taught on Saturday. And that's what I'm going to be doing. Right here, there is a live link that when I click on it, will take me to a visual menu on what is being taught. It shows you the times, it shows you the name of the model, and who's teaching it. And you scroll down and you can see everything that's being offered. One of the things that Origami USA has put on the website is a nice little sheet, a worksheet that can help you with setting up your classes. You can write the name of the class, what time it starts. You can write down what your preference order is, maybe what your top choice. You can do one for each day. Another thing that I did that I think might be helpful for some people is I printed off a draft copy of the visual menu in black and white to save on ink, and just so that I could see it and write on it and circle and make stars and notes. So that then when I'm ready to actually do it on the computer, I know what I'm doing and what I actually want. So here we have the visual menu. Now I want to go back to my request page. And if you notice, there is a long rectangular box. When I put my cursor on it and I click, that box changes colors. On my computer, it turned blue. That shows that you can type something in it and the computer will recognize. So I'm going to type one of the classes that I'm interested in taking for Saturday. I'm going to look at my little handy dandy worksheet and I'm going to type in Bassetta Star. I must have spelled it wrong because it's not coming up. There it is. Okay, so you can see if you only type part of it in, it will give you listings that have that base in it. So that helps me out. because I wasn't spelling it correctly. Now, if you notice, I put my arrow on this thing, this little box here, and it turns, on my computer, it's a dark blue. If I click on it, then that whole thing goes inside this box that was blue. That means that now I can request it. If all that information is not within this little blue box, the computer will not know what you're requesting and you'll probably get an error message. So if you get an error message, go back and make sure that the whole description, including the time, the day, everything is in there. Once you have that, you'll see a little button that says Request Class. Put your arrow and click. Let the computer do the work. You'll get a green banner up here that says, now the Bachetta Star has been added to your class request list. Again, this is just a class request list. It is not actually signing up for the class yet. All right, let's try another one. Let's say I know that I want to see if Robert Lang is teaching anything. And he is. He's teaching the Taiwan goldfish. So I put my arrow, it turns blue. I click on it. Now it's inside my box. I can click on it, the request class, let the computer do the work. I get a green banner that tells me now these are now in my class list, my request list. So there are two ways to look up classes. You can look them up by the name of the class or the person teaching. And as you can see, it will start recognizing just a few letters and will bring you up sometimes a string of classes that have those letters in it. And that's a little bit helpful, I think, to help you know what you wanna pick. So now I'm gonna turn off my camera and I'm gonna add a bunch more classes so I can show you a few more features on this program. Right, I'm back, and as you can see, I've added more classes for Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. I wanna point out that I have 13 classes on Saturday. That is not nearly enough. The more, the better. And if I click on my link to see my Saturday classes, I wanna point out that I don't have many afternoon classes. So I need to go back and look at the schedule again and add some more classes for the afternoon. There is no limit to how many classes you can request, and more is better. One of the things, if you add too few classes or you request too few, you may end up with some blanks in your schedule if all the classes you have requested sell out before it's your turn for the computer to process your request. Right, now I want to show you about moving these into a preference order. What we would like for you to do is put all the classes that you want the most at the top of your list for each particular day. So for Saturday, I'm going to look down on my class list and I'm going to decide which is the most important class for me to have on Saturday. Right now, Bachetta Star is my top pick, or my, not my top pick, but my top preference class for Saturday. And really, I'm looking, and I think what I really, really would like to take more is the Origami World Globe, and here it is at the bottom. Well, I can move it all the way up to the top by bringing my cursor over to this left-hand menu bar, which has little plus signs, and when I put my arrow over it, it becomes a bigger plus sign, and it gives me a little hint that says drag to reorder. So all I do is click and I start dragging, and as you can see, I'm moving it. I can move it up, I can move it down, but in my case, I'm gonna move it up here to the very top. And you'll notice we get a yellow bulletin. This is very important. If you see this yellow bulletin, it means that you need to do some saving. And you have two places that you could click: Save Preference Order here, or down here. There are two places So in case you're scrolling up, you don't see the bottom one, you have it here. But always, whenever you have this yellow bulletin, that means you haven't saved what you have just done. So I'm going to go ahead and save that. And as computer thinks, now I don't have the yellow bulletin anymore, and I know that the computer has saved my classes in the order that I really want them. So now the way I have it is Origami World Globe is my top preference for Saturday, even though it's at 2 o'clock. That's fine. It doesn't have to be the beginning of the day. In fact, all of your preferred classes for Saturday might be in the afternoon. That's just fine. The computer will assign the classes as it comes to it. It will fill in all your time periods as it goes along, so don't worry about the time order. The next class that I think I really, really want to take on Saturday is the bunny. So I'm going to put my cursor over here and I'm going to move it up. And there it is. You see I have the yellow bulletin. I need to save it, so I click on change. Save preference order. Now at any time, you can close out of this window. We have no bulletins telling us that we need to save anything. So I can click out of Origami USA and come back tomorrow when I have a little bit more time to work on it. Let's say that happens and I'm back again and I'm looking at my schedule for Saturday and I just really can't remember what this hyperbolic parabola looks like. So one way I can find out is by putting my arrow over this, the title, and you see my cursor changes. That means it's a live link. And if I click on it, it takes me to a very nice page that tells me all about it. It tells me who's teaching it, tells me the creator. It tells me how many people can be in this class, which I think is a really handy thing that the web team has done for us. I really appreciate that. So now I see that and I think, yes, I do want to keep that on my schedule, but I'm not sure I want to keep Rooster. So how do I remove something that I've already put on my schedule? If you look over here, you have a right menu bar that has all these little buttons that say remove. And you guessed it, put your arrow over the remove button and click. The computer will do its work and now it's gone. You don't see a yellow save button. You haven't changed the preference order. The computer will now remember this. This is your class request list. It is stable now. Again, if you decide you want to add, you come back up to this rectangular box. You put your cursor on it, make it click to become a blue box, and then start typing to request a class. Always remember to press request class in order for it to go down in your list. Just typing it in here does not put it in your list. You must type request class. Okay, I think I have gone over the major features on how to request, add, subtract, reorder your preferences for each day. You need to do this whole process for Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. Once you do that, let's go back to the class schedule. And let's assume I have done that for all the days that I'm taking classes. I've added all the classes I want. I have them in the order that they're most important to me. And now we're going to go to the top picks feature. This is a new feature that aims to give everyone one of their top class choices throughout the whole convention, not just Saturday, Sunday, or Monday, but throughout the convention period before the regular class assignments are processed. The top picks can be for any day on which you're attending classes. So let's go ahead and look at what top picks and how that works. So you already have your Saturday listed and what your top order. You have your Sunday listed in preference order, Monday also. Now, these are the classes that you want across the board. If you had to pick one class and you could only get one class, what would that class be? Okay, so for me, I'm looking over my class list, and I think it would be origami jewelry. Oops, I'm sorry. Yes, I forgot to explain. This works the same way down here. You can add individual classes, and you click in just like you did on the other page, and it becomes blue, and I will type in origami jewelry. And I scroll down here, it turns blue, I click on it, and then I request it. Now I see that origami jewelry down here is the class that I really want to take at convention. But I may not have the preference order of number 1 through 25 or 1 through 10 or whatever number once origami jewelry is sold out. If my sign-up number is 200, I might not get an origami jewelry. So I'm going to have to add more top choices, more top picks throughout the convention. As you notice, this top pick is on Monday. That's what I really want. That's what I'm going to put. It can be Saturday, Sunday. It doesn't matter. So I'm going to remove this now just to show you the other feature that when we had our testing period, we had some of our testers suggest that we put all of the classes that we have requested in our class top pick list, so they didn't have to retype all of them. So that is what this is for, and it's optional. You can click on this button and it will copy all your requests for all the days onto your list of top picks. So I'm going to say it says sync top picks to day picks. And there I get a thing that tells me. Now this can be a very long list. If you've requested a lot of classes, which you should for each day. So what you might do that will make it a little bit more speedy is go through and say, no, that's really not a top pick. That's not a top pick. I'm going to remove it. That's not a top pick. I'm going to remove it. You can go through and remove the ones that you know you really don't want that much. Because what's really important is probably the top 5 or 6, maybe even the top 10, depending on our attendance, of course. These will be the ones that you will be most likely to get during this first round. So my top pick is World Globe on Saturday here. If that's what I want, I will keep it. I could change it to the Seminole Place piecework with paper on Monday. As you see, as I move this up, I get my yellow bulletin that tells me, please save the changes. Don't ever forget that. Don't ever close out your browser while you have a yellow bulletin showing. That's your clue that you need to do something else. All right, so again, you can have as many here as you want, but the most important ones are the very top ones. These should be your top choices across all days of convention. All right, so I've saved my preference order. I'm going to go back to my class schedule. And now you can see I have 12 for Monday, 12 for Sunday, 12 for Saturday, 12 for Sunday, 5 for Monday, and 25 for my top picks. I would urge you to put as many picks as you can so you don't end up with empty spaces in your schedule. One of the things I'd like to just point out last is if we go to the schedule page, the visual menu, you will notice that some classes are 2 periods long, some are even 3 periods long, and you want to make sure you have lots of choices if you put a 1 period class, because you don't want an empty space at 11 o'clock if you just put 1 choice for this particular time period. So if you're wanting a 2 classes within the morning, you need to put down several different picks for that morning time slot. All right, so we're going to go back to my class schedule. And now I am ready. I can go ahead and leave. If you notice that I, just one more point, that I have 2 people on my schedule page, that is because in 2017 I registered Yamaguchi-san, so he now appears on my convention schedule. Yeah, he won't next year because I won't be registering him, but most people will have just their own schedule unless you registered somebody else. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. I hope that you give this new system a chance. If you read the documentation, I think you will see and agree that this is a much fairer system than the on-site ticketing. But never worry, because we will have some on-site ticketing. So if there is a class that you have an empty space for, there still be a chance that you can fill that in at the convention. We will have hotlines and we will have emails that if you are having trouble with this system, we're more than happy to help you out. Give us a chance. I think you will enjoy this new system, and I think it will make your Friday evening, Saturday morning, Sunday mornings more relaxed and enjoyable at convention. Thanks for your time. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in June.